serving mid-Michigan. This is NBC 25 Up Close with Kathy Hoekstra.
And welcome to this week's edition of Up Close. Among many of the things we recognize during the month of March, there's something that could save your life or that of a loved one. We're talking about Kidney Cancer Awareness Month, and we've got a special guest today here to talk about it with us and help us sort out some of the facts. We are talking to Frank Friedman, who is associated with the Kidney Cancer Association. Welcome to the program. Thank you for being here, Kathy.
I'm very glad to be here.
Well, first of all, Frank, what got you so passionate about this topic?
Well, I had a son who had some, you know, problems, but we didn't know it was kidney related. And 2 years ago, he came down with chronic bronchitis, and he was diagnosed at McLaren Hospital, and it took about 3 or 4 weeks for him to heal. And then the following year, the same thing happened. Hmm. We went back on a snowy day on January 6, 2005, I remember directly, to emergency at McLaren, and they said, well, you have bronchitis again. I said, no, I think that's something more severe. We got him over on Friday, January 14. They did an ultrasound on him. They found both kidneys had metastasized.
Oh my goodness.
Which means cancer.
Sure.
And the signs are very, very difficult for people to recognize. It can be difficult for anybody. But when you stop eating much, and also when you can't defecate or urinate, and your kidneys shut down, you know, have a problem. So they attended to him immediately. My wife and I stayed with him for a whole month, and it was already too late. Mm. He had succumbed in February of 2005. But I mean, he was only 38, and yet the statistics show that basically one doesn't come down with kidney cancer. Now, this is different from kidney disease.
Sure.
You know, kidney cancer basically is something that will originate with a person, let's say, 50 years or older, but it's very unusual for a person in his 30s to come down with it, yet it's humanly possible. So I got very involved.
I was just going to say, needless to say, you dove in and you started finding out the facts.
I wanted to find out as much as I could.
Well, you mentioned the difference between kidney cancer and kidney disease. Mm-hmm. I want to, if you could help our viewers understand the difference between these.
Well, kidney cancer, they talk about kidney disease. By definition, it's a disease where one or more multiple tumors are formed on your kidneys. That's kidney cancer, whereas kidney disease is not like that. Kidney disease can come from so many different things. And this little brochure I have from one of the organizations will tell you if you're at risk, and there are warning signs for disease. Many people will come down with kidney disease, but how do you decipher it?
Sure.
Well, there's what basically everybody's called CKD, chronic kidney disease. And this includes high blood pressure, blood in the urine. When you go for a physical, usually they use what's called creatinine. Mm-hmm. It's like a blood test. It's 1.2 for women, 1.4 for men. Also, frequent urination at night is a warning sign. And even your eyes can puff up. Now, people don't know that. Or your hands could swell up, or even your feet. And also, you could have shortness of breath, loss of appetite, nausea. This is something unusual, and yet you can be at risk for any one of these things. Now, sometimes it might be genetic. I met people, because after my son was diagnosed, I went over and I had a test, and they want to take my kidney out right away. I said, wait a minute, you don't do that. You go for a second opinion, I mean, when it's severe. So I went to Ann Arbor Hospital, and they said, thank goodness, there was no need to take out your kidney. What they found was a cyst on one side and a benign tumor on the right. So it's something I can live with. So I'm diagnosed every year. Yet, with my son, there's no history in the family at all. It's just like somebody coming down with lung cancer and not being exposed to secondhand smoke. Mm. I mean, where does this happen? But another thing, too, you have to watch your diet. You have to be careful of things that have a lot of fat in it, trans fat or otherwise. Two things that you want to know about kidney disease is that if you have diabetes and also high blood pressure, hypertension, I found out in talking to the Genesis Hurley Cancer Institute, March, they were so receptive, but there were people there that had all different kinds of cancers, but yet this is a very, very big group made up of people that may be in remission or relatives that may have had cancer, and they were just overwhelmed. Turned out there were two people there. One woman had a child who had a kidney disease at age 10.
Okay, and that was kidney disease.
Yeah, kidney, yeah.
Actually, it turned out it was kidney cancer. Okay.
And he had it removed. And she says he's healthy, because you can live with one good kidney.
As you mentioned, a lot of people hear about kidney disease and talk about kidney disease.
Yeah.
But kidney cancer seems to be also just as important.
But I mean, if you have kidney disease, that doesn't mean necessarily that you would have kidney cancer.
Okay.
Those on kidney disease, they may be on hemodialysis. Kidneys may shut down and pass away, but that doesn't mean they have cancer. All those warning signals that I gave you could contribute actually to kidney disease. My feeling is this: you've got to get a checkup. I mean, so many people are very apprehensive about going to doctors. You can't believe it. And they don't do anything until something happens to them. But so many people could be shown that they may have diabetes, but they don't know about it. So what I have said to many, many people, don't hesitate. Life is so important. You've got to get a checkup.